Now, how are you doing there, Takis?
You ever heard of a guy named Gabriel Tosh?
Only rumors. Way I hear it, he was mixed up in some covert branch of the Ghost Program that produced some real scary badasses. Word was, Tosh snapped and went rogue. I'd play it real cool with that can. He'd cut your throat soon as look at you.
I've dealt with rogue ghosts before. It's the one still working for Menx I got a problem with.
Donny Vermillion, UNN, your first, last, and only stop for the truth. Tonight, our own Kate Lockwell uncovers a secret shadow war waged by our brave Dominion ghosts against a ruthless hidden enemy.
Thanks, Donny. I'm talking live with a specialist in the Dominion. I understand that you and your comrades have been against a group of. What can you tell us about that?
Well, Kate, I'm not allowed to say much. But I can tell you, and his allies will not. We expect them very soon.
I think we'll all sleep a little better tonight, knowing our Dominion forces are watching over us. For UNN, I'm Donny Vermillion.
So from that censorship, you got to assume that they're probably saying the exact opposite of what the message is that he's trying to get across. Or they're just trying to do a joke about unnecessary censorship because it's kind of funny to just randomly censor words and then it's just implied that the word they said must have been something naughty. What can we do here? I thought new research... There it is. I was like, I could have sworn it said last time that new research was available. Just to wait for it to go crawling up all creepy-like. Planetary defense. Command centers can be outfitted with twin Ibix cannon? Oh, command centers can get a gun? That's kind of cool. Flame turret. Conceals itself when out of combat. Huh. So do you want to place a secret flame turret on the ground for defensive purposes, or do you want your command center just to have an automatic defense, is the question here. I do love my turrets in every RTS. These are both turrets, basically. But yeah, I gotta admit that I've always been a big fan of turrets in these games because I like feeling like my base isn't about to be destroyed. So it's very tempting. But at the same time, this is just bam, right there on your main base that you already have, and no extra stuff has to be done. Well, you probably have to build the actual cannon. You probably don't get it on your base by default, but this is something you have to manually place. That said, you can put this at your choke points, cover your base. That way, whenever I can be less jumpy about these moments, like that last lava level I did, where I was running my entire team away from my base, and then obviously being a little concerned about what might happen when I'm gone. I like the idea of them. The bad news, of course, is that they don't attack aerial units at all. But we already do have an air turret, so that's good too. I'll grab it. The funny thing is that, just thinking about the online version of this game, has got to be this ever-changing meta, and they got to be updating and patching and removing and adding units and doing all these changes. So, I bet that the online and offline versions of this game, like the campaign versus the multiplayer, probably just flat-out have different units at this point, considering how much time has passed since this game came out, and they probably haven't changed the campaign that much in the meantime. Look at that Zerg tank. It continues to evolve. Clearly has motor function despite lack of anything like a neural cortex. It's giving off more heat than it could possibly be absorbing in the tank. I'm learning how some Zerg burrow so well. It's extremely sophisticated. They have billions of tiny muscles that vibrate at low frequency, effectively loosening soil, crumbling rock, and snapping vegetation. They can swim through the ground. It's not quite as fast as running, but it's close. I can see a way to put this knowledge to good use. And that's probably how we got the turret. It's just a nasty little piece of fleshy-looking stuff. Even though it's a pretty... it's pretty well done. It's just a polygonal model, but they make it flop around in just a creepy enough way that it sets itself apart from all the stuff that's not normally supposed to look like that.
Just out of curiosity, I did some tests on the minerals from Redstone. I thought you should know I found trace quantities of Jorium, a rare crystal with very unique properties.
I'm all ears, Doc. What kind of properties?
Jorium resonates at the same frequency as certain brainwaves. It's been theorized that it could be used to stimulate brain activity or even produce psionic abilities in human subjects.
What the hell does Tosh want that for?
And we're off to the armory. What can I get for my money this time? I'm trying to stray towards this place and less towards the mercenaries, just because I feel like permanent upgrades to characters around here could be a good idea. So I can upgrade my missile turrets to have more life or an additional volley of projectiles with each attack, meaning increased damage per shot. Obvious bonuses to Hellions. Let's see, being able to get medics without the tech lab add-on would actually be pretty nice. It means that you could just build them non-stop. These guys still require it, at least these two do, I don't know what if that guy does. But it means that a base that specializes in just marines could also make medics when I do the one that just lets them build twice as fast. That said, bonus armor's nice. Slows are nice. How much do these cost? Oh wow. These prices are all over the place. I think I'm gonna keep working on survivability upgrades. I gave him 25 hit points, so let's give him 2 armor. These are expensive upgrades. You really do get to do like one per mission, and that's only if things are going well, really. Anything new here? There you are.
Ah, he is the man. We make a good team, me and you.
Why are you here, Tosh? Our business is done unless you got something else for me.
Yeah, I got another job for us on a world called Belshia. Interested?
Maybe. But what's in it for me? Piracy ain't exactly my chosen path.
Everyone knows Jim Raynor wants to put the hurt on Mengsk. I can help you with that. I can help you big time.
I'll think about it. For the time being, welcome aboard the Hyperion. We'll talk later.
What's next around here? I'm honestly just thinking of going left or right half the time.
There's a rare gas on Belshia, the Protoss skull, the breath of creation. They think it'd be a gift from their gods. We call it Tarazine, and it'd be worth a fortune to the right bidder. Of course, those Protoss will kill us if they catch us on their holy ground. Or at least they'll try.
Going against the Protoss. Probably not always the best call. Apparently not going to stop me.
Here we go. Much prettier than Redstone, yeah?
I don't much like fighting Protoss if I can avoid it.
Not just any old Protoss. Fanatics called the Tal Darim. They believe the Tarazine is sacred. A gift from the Zelnaga.
If these Tal Darim bring in their air power, they're gonna hammer us. Swan, get the Goliath schematics loaded at the factory. If their anti-air missiles are still any good, we might just pull this off.
All right, cowboy. I'll get the Goliath schematics loaded so we can build more.
How do we get to the Tarazine?
See those altars? Tal Darim mystics set them up to collect the Tarazine. We just need to grab it.
Well, our SCVs will be able to haul the Tarazine. We just gotta keep them protected. With any luck, we can pick up what we need before the Tal Darim find us. All right, let's get to it.
Mission name, Welcome to the Jungle. Get you guys started, huh? Always with these. Oops. Slightly mismapped. There we go. We start off with Goliaths.
Here are the coordinates for the Tarazine sites, brother. This should make our lives a little easier.
Our SCVs can pick up Tarazine canisters and move them. It'll take them a while to disconnect the canister, so make sure you watch out for them.
So we're starting off with 3 Goliaths right here. Definitely want to pump up our mineral gathering rate. So we need 7 Tarazine, which is all the more reason to have more SCVs around. So we need to watch out on the idea that they can apparently seal 7 of them. So if 7 makes them win and 7 makes me win, I assume that means that there's a total of 13. On top of that, there's relics out there somewhere. Okay. Hello, factory. Let's see, you guys can be 2, actually. That makes sense for units. Let's see, so a regular barracks will be 3, factory will be 1. There's a Goliath. We'll probably just want to build a few of those just for starters. And we'll go with the tech lab. Let's not immediately go jumping into this kind of stuff yet. Hello, you. We're going to need to start working on some shelters. Oh, right. Always a mineral problem, huh? There we go. Some of this early bit's just a little bit of waiting, really. Complete. I mean, we might as well have one of you guys wander on over. Hey, you. So go here. And then take it back to the base, I assume? There we go. Believe that's how that works. Believe that's exactly how that works. Alright. I need another one of you guys just to keep up with the rate of all this. We don't need more than one. I was planning on multitasking there, but we just don't get the minerals fast enough. So we can't actually keep up with it. Are you dying? No, it's a progress bar. Okay. Huh. Okay. Just keep an eye on it, I guess. We'll keep busy. And with both of you guys mapped to that guy, we can keep people headed your way. Get a few medics in there. Keep our population ahead of things, we'll be good to go. Just don't want to deal with people being stuck behind us anymore. Not really planning on using them as barriers.
This land was sacred to the Talmudim before Terrans ever reached the stars. You must depart immediately.
Hold on now. We just need some of this gas here, and we'll be long gone before you know it.
No. You shall not defile the breath of creation. Talmudim warriors. Execute all those who desecrate our altars.
The Protoss are mobilizing, sir. Looks like they're gonna go after our SCVs when we harvest the Terrazine. I suggest we only harvest one side at a time and run with a heavy escort.
That's more or less what I'm going for. Looking to find out where the Protoss are hanging out first.
Good job. That's the first canister field.
Your forces are under attack.
I'm sure they can manage. I believe in them? What's that? Oh, there's a relic. Destroy! Alright, focus on that guy over there first. Okay, never mind, this was a mistake. They've actually got a really big base there, that was not just an outcrop.
Warning. The Tal'Darim are sealing off a Terrazine altar.
Yeah, that's great.
Tal'Darim are sealing off the Terrazine altar, so we can't get at them. If they keep it up, we won't be able to collect enough.
Kind of a bad spot to be in. Poor medic. Bring one of you guys back real quick. We definitely need more of these. We just need faster output right now. Okay, so, genuine base right there. not just some random Protoss to deal with. So now I've got less troops than I started with. That is a blow. I want to get some tankier units in there to supplement the situation. You still crafting? Nope. We need to pump up our worker count. I wonder, does it cost resources to repair that guy? Probably, huh? Maybe not? I don't know. What I do know is I don't have more than one medic yet, which means that, it means that these characters don't get healed. The medics don't heal each other, unfortunately. Because it's not... I mean, the medics are not being healed because there aren't other medics. Which is problematic. Population's fine. Let's just get him on minerals for now. Still not there, huh? All right. There's 50. So trying to seal one off around here. Oh, that's that guy. Oh, they already sealed it off. It's over. Okay. We'll get on that. I'll have to accept that some of them are going to happen that way. We'll have to try to remember that guy over here. There's definitely a demand this time around for having a supply for the Vespian gas, just for the Goliath situation, if nothing else. Let's get you busy. It'd be dumb not to buy Goliaths for the mission that's clearly designed for Goliaths. Like, that's the premise of it. Yeah, wow. I think there's only two surviving units from the original group. Four, maybe? Might want to just call some of these guys in to, yeah, to complement ourselves, our troops quickly. Whenever I'm ready to head out. Right now, we got to deal with the rate of this. We're just not getting crystals fast enough, and I'm gonna pay for it.
The Tal'Darim are sealing off a Terrazine altar.
I could try it. Let's see. We just don't have them yet. Come on. There we go. They'll catch up. Let's see if I can stop them from sealing the altar. How long does it take? They're getting there. It's probably kind of comparable to how long it takes for me to grab the relic in the first place. It's the death time. There we go. At least they're alive. That's a start. At least we get a warning. Oh, hey. Surprise. Any more surprises? Oh, look. Let's not take that route, huh? Let's not. Haha. Careful. Let's see. I'll grab one little guy. One little guy to wander over really quick. I just want to have this. Nyah. Alright, we're good. Just calling the extra troops because they're faster. We're going to want more buildings soon. I'm out of minerals. Having a tough time. Get one of you on repair duty again. Might just have a few SVC permanent members of that squad over there with how much they come under fire. Just be the equivalent of medics for this group. Come on, minerals. Alright, we're 1-1. It's what? Whoa, it's already 10 minutes? I just looked at the clock. Does not feel like we've been playing for 10 minutes already. Okay. Could do with an engine. Oh, we already have an engineering bay. And I can afford the upgrades already. Probably should. Early game investments make the points worth it. Make sure that we have the resources for the rest of the game, basically. Not resources, I mean, like, we'll have more capable units that are less likely to go down over the course of the fight. And if they're less likely to go down later, that means I'm less likely to need them in the future to make more of them.
The Tal'Darim are sealing off a Terrazine altar.
You are you? Well, that one looks way harder to get to, unless that path's gonna be useful. And somehow I doubt that. You guys both on someone selectable? Cool. Bring in a couple fire bats. Low on gas. That's actively a problem. At this point, I might as well bring the SVCs SCVs with me to both repair the units, but also to hopefully take down the actual gas when we get there. Oh yeah, it's not quite close enough to their base. Get them. There we go. Anyone else here to stop me? Yeah, you are. I just killed my own unit. That just happened. God damn it. I meant to stop giving them movement commands and tell them, hey, let's just, you know, attack the ground here. I blew up a Goliath. I killed my own Goliath. God damn it. Alright, where's my... Are they dead somehow? No, they're not. Wait, did they seal it off successfully? They did. You son of a bitch. That was fast. Go grab the other one then, I guess. Can you help him or not? Actually, don't know. I'll keep you guys busy. I put him on patrol because otherwise they'll chase enemies away. And I don't want them to actually leave the location if enemies come up to them and surprise us. That's a little overkill right now. I want you to be on building duty, though. There we go.
Your forces are under attack.
I just want the basic entrance to our base to be defended if we're going to be sending people on missions like this. Alright. I must have killed the one that they were supposed to chase after, too. Alright. Send some Goliaths in.
Upgrade complete.
There we go. Not ready for any reinforcements yet, and we still don't have the contract with those guys. Is that the only new contract that's shown up, is the one? It's kind of a surprise, I just figured that there'd be more more contracts available by now. I thought it was almost going to be like a mission-by-mission like cost to deal with. I should deal with the gas problem. Crap, there it is. Hello? Whoa, you just came right back over here. Okay.
The Tal'Darim are sealing off a Terrazine altar.
I'm sure they are. Which one is that? Oh, we've been there before. We can get there. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. Ah. Take the shortcut over here. Stick to the corner to not attract attention, hopefully. They just got him, didn't they? No, they're still in progress. Take out that guy first. There we go. Oh my goodness. They're not happy we're here. Who would have thought? They seem somehow displeased by our presence. Alright, well if that's happening, we should definitely send one of these guys over to deal with these. Might as well just grab them now, right? I need to add one to the crew, too. Just bring a few of them over here. There we go. Just join the crew. Or we're gonna be in trouble anyway.
Good move, Mr. Raynor. Collecting Terrazine from two places at once.
Sure, it's gonna be harder to keep the Tal'Darim off our backs. But the quicker we're done here, the sooner we can get off this rock.
Incoming transmission.
You shall not steal the breath of creation so easily. Careful. They're sending their ships to take out your SCVs. Shoot them down quick, or we're finished.
Upgrade complete.
Where are they coming from? Population problems. Take them down, come on. There we go. There we go. That's good. I love these guys as a source of just quick units. Alright, I'm about to have 4. That's a hell of a leap ahead of their progress. Alright. Babysitting time. No one's gonna be cutting through. Not this time. That's good. Alright.
Warning. The Tal'Darim are sealing off a Terrazine altar.
They like to do that.
Down. You're doing great. Keep it up.
That's over half the canisters you wanted.
Got him. You guys stuck somehow? Oh, you're just here to hang out. Really, you guys should stick with this crew, really. You'll go back down here. We're constantly upsizing, so let's just keep adding more wherever they fit around here. There we go. No more of that happening for now. Oh. I'm about to just try to stomp their whole base. I'm not getting to that other one they're sealing right now. Anytime soon. Am I? Nope.
Damn those Tal'Darim.
I'm getting ready to stomp their base.
They shut down, sets us back further. You need to get some of your boys out there and stop them.
Yeah, I'm working on it. Here's a billion units. How does this feel? There we go. That takes care of the turret problem, at least. Alright. How's everyone feeling today? Damn, it gets noisy. I somehow got 6 SCVs in this group. Not sure how that happened, but I seem to have enough anyway, though. I'll build just a few more, because we have the resources now. There we go. Right now, one of our biggest concerns is just the population thing. No regrets, no regrets. Hit that cap, no regrets. I'll keep him busy. Keep those going. Decent chunks there. Alright. How's this crew doing? 5 more just came in. Good. We're gonna get busy. I'm gonna take over everything I can around here.
Warning. The Tal'Darim are sealing off a Terrazine altar.
Yeah, I'm working on it. I'm working on it. Come on. We're good? Alright. You go after that guy. You go after that guy. One of you go after that. There we go. That'll be 2 more. Howdy. This is what getting destroyed looks like, usually. In case you were unclear. It's a bad time to be you. Can't go too far ahead because they have flying units, so I don't want to be ahead of that. And get surprised. But this will take me to... this will take me to 6 out of 7. This is such a cloud of units right now.
Forces are under attack.
This is silly. Well, I mean, if they don't get behind me, we're good. Might as well just knock their entire damn gate down. Oh, Okay, I might learn to regret this one. You never know. You know, let's just force our way into the base first.
Mineral field depleted.
There we go. Big old cloud of death right here. You guys heading back to base? There are other
your
2 points. Good. They can do it.
You and your radar sure can walk the walk. We just need one more canister.
Also, let's destroy their main base. Why not? Screw it. This is silly and I love it. Oh my god, it's just a cloud of danger. Everything's just going down. I do want these guys closer together. I don't like them spreading out too much. There we go. Yeah, they have a primary opposition force that's going down at this point. They must be building units around here. Uh-oh. Take out the big bat if you can. This is such a giant mess.
Your forces are under attack.
I don't even care. This is silly and I love it.
Mineral field.
That was weird how it got quiet halfway through that line. I mean, I'm building units faster than they can destroy them, that's something. I would be a terrible leader. So don't let me do that, I guess.
Your forces are under attack.
I'm trying to make sure I attack their pylons first so that their various defenses, such as turrets and so on, all go down earlier. And of course, anything nearby stops working. Because that's how the Protoss do.
Your forces are under attack.
And damn if they aren't covered in crystals.
Your forces are under attack.
I feel like this has to be hurting their chances of sealing all of the gases when I destroy their entire base.
Mineral field depleted.
It's probably not great for them. Damn, there's a lot of groups here. Take out what you can. There we go. Every pylon.
Are under attack.
They basically don't have a base anymore, right? Still have an in population cap. That's good. Everyone's in pain, but still. Do I have No, I have medics in there. They just don't seem to. Yeah, they're still healing people. It's just that so many of the units in my group are mechanical by nature. Take it out. Oh, there's always more turrets. Damn. They're dense with this stuff, aren't they? I did always like Protoss as a kid because of all the turrets. I was a fan. But yeah, over the course of this battle, our number of units has only increased. Well, howdy ho, huh? So, not really the intended way to play the mission. You're supposed to beat them in their arms race, not destroy their entire base, but I think we might not have enemies anymore. So that's fun. Still gonna keep building Goliaths. No regrets. Let's see, can I find their Protoss relics? Where are you hiding them, huh? Don't you want to tell me? Is that a Protoss relic? That might be a Protoss relic. I just want to get there. First of all, that's not a CV. Let's see. Is there even anyone left, or they all died? Nope, they're not dead. Can you get you? Yeah, you're over there. Oh, look. They have a whole base over here. Better take them out. Oh wow, it's just some turrets, and like nothing else.
These reckless Terrans must be stopped. Slay them all.
There we go, we're clear. Just gonna grab this relic now, don't mind me. Yay! Now murder all of the things. Oh, where are you even coming from? There's no more screen over there. Were you just floating off in the distance? I wonder if they seeded enemies into the map, just to make sure that there's always something to do, go on. Alright, we got 2 out of 3, and that last Terrazine's gonna make me win. If I was reasonable, I would've just done that sooner, because obviously there's more Terrazine somewhere. They only sealed... They sealed 4. They got reasonably close to their victory. Yeah, that one's sealed. It was that one or the 2 that were up further north. Last relic's probably over here by this turret. Where's the one that's gonna make me... Where's the victory, SBC? Can I tell him to stop? Oh, there he is.
Your forces are under attack.
Do I have control over you? I do. Good. Can I tell you to hang out over here and not run over there? Will he stand still? Looks like it. Must destroy all Protoss. There's a relic somewhere.
The Tal'Darim just can't stand up to our firepower. They're in full retreat. Well done, sir.
Oh, there it is. No! No!
The last canister. I think we've outstayed our welcome, boys.
That's mean. I was standing right in front of it, and they didn't let me get it, did they? Oh, 2 out of 3. No.
Sir, I received an encrypted transmission from an untraceable source. It claims that Tosh here was part of a classified operation called Project Shadowblade. They used Jorium and Terrazine to enhance ghost powers.
It's true. We are called Spectres. Next generation ghosts.
And you were gonna tell me all this when?
We all have our secrets, Mr. Rena. Doesn't mean I'm any threat to you.
Maybe not. But whoever sent this message could be. Matt, any way to verify the transmission?
No, sir. But it does end with, I'll be in touch soon.
It's Minsk, trying to turn us against each other. Don't let him.
I'll let it lie for now. At least till I find out who sent this transmission. But I'll be keeping an eye on you, Tosh.
You can try.